Welcome to this instructional video on installing the Arnott Coil Spring Conversion Kit with EBM for various long wheelbase GM SUVs, GMT9xx. We'll guide you through the process to ensure a smooth and safe installation experience. Before starting, ensure you have the necessary safety measures in place which can be found in the vehicle owner's manual. Lift and immobilize the vehicle properly and isolate any stored energy to prevent injuries or damage. Raise the vehicle and remove the front wheels to expose the front coil struts. Next, lift the hood to expose the top of the coil struts. Then locate and disconnect the electrical connectors. Secure the harness so it does not interfere with any moving parts or components with excessive heat. Now remove the wire clips as well as the top mounting nuts. Now remove the lower mounting bolts and loosen, but do not remove the sway bar end link hardware. You can now carefully remove the coil struts from the vehicle. Use a spring compressor tool for the following removal steps. Release the clip and remove the top electrical connector and the shock rod stem. Now compress the coil spring and remove the top shock rod nut. Next, remove the top mount plate, the offset plate, and the rubber isolator. Carefully release spring pressure and remove the coil spring, spacer washer, bump stop cap, and the spring seat. Now install the OEM spring seat, making sure the flanged end of the spring seat is down. Then install the bump stop cap onto the new shock absorber. Properly align the strut before installing it on the vehicle, making sure the bolt mounts are facing downward as shown here. The remaining assembly and installation is in the reverse order of shock removal. Tighten all nuts and bolts to the vehicle manufacturer's specifications to ensure a secure and proper fit. Position the T-bar on top of the control arm to ensure proper mounting. Start the rear air shock and coil spring removal by setting the steering straight. Then raise the vehicle and remove the rear wheels. Now locate and remove the airlines to deflate the air shocks. Turn the metal clip approximately 90 degrees to remove the airline fitting from the air shock. Then locate and remove the electrical connectors from the top of the air shocks. Next, loosen and remove the upper and lower shock mounting nuts. Support the axle to relieve pressure from the air shock's mounting points and remove the upper and lower air shock mounting bolts. You are now able to remove the air shocks from the vehicle. Next, remove the bolts and ride height sensors from the upper control arms. Now remove the bolt and the bracket holding the brake line to the rear differential. Also remove the nuts on the upper sway bar end links. Using a jack or other suitable device, support the axle to release pressure from the sway bar end link bolts. Now slowly lower the axle and remove the coil springs. Install the new rear coil conversion in the reverse order of removal. Tighten all nuts and bolts to the vehicle manufacturer's specifications to ensure a secure and proper fit. Secure the airlines and electrical connectors in suitable locations as they are not used for this kit. Start the electronic bypass module installation by removing the side fuse box cover, the lower dash hardware, and the lower dash cover. Next, remove the OBD mounting screw and drop the plug down. Remove the air conditioning duct and trim back the plug harness sheath. Using the wiring diagram, match up the wires and splice them together with the T-tap connectors. Once all the wires have been connected, you will need to secure the EBM under the dash. Make sure to secure it away from any source of heat and moving parts. Now reassemble the dash by reinstalling the air conditioning duct, the lower dash cover, the lower dash hardware, and the side fuse box cover. The EBM installation is now complete. Remove the cover from the fuse box in the engine compartment. Remove the 30 ampere fuse in location 2 labeled as electronic suspension control auto level control exhaust. If the fuse is not removed, a warning light will be displayed on the instrument cluster. Now reinstall the fuse box cover and the installation is complete. Thank you for following our guide on installing an Arnott coil conversion kit. Proper installation ensures the longevity and performance of your vehicle's suspension system. Stay safe and happy repairing.